I have like 1,000 of these sitting in my inbox. When I was a kid, I could only dream of a world where robots could do research and come up with brownie recipes. And yet, here we are, flooded with this impersonal slop. I don't know a single person who enjoys this, and somehow this low-effort, cold outreach is alive and thriving. So what's going on? I'll argue that I think this is a poor execution of what could otherwise be a sophisticated, and dare I say, artful process: lead generation. So let's talk about it. AI lead generation. What it is, why AI is particularly well suited for generating leads, and how you could drum up business in ways that aren't so ethnically charged. Let's roll. Then I'm gonna do some cool intro music. All businesses need customers. And when you think about it, everybody is a potential customer. And so if you could sit down and have a meaningful conversation with everybody about their business needs, then eventually you'd curate a perfect client base. But you can't do that. So you get clever about it. Lead generation. Lead generation is about orienting your resources towards people who are most likely to become paying customers. Throw up a billboard on the I-90 or take out an ad on local cable. But when the calls come pouring in, what do?
Lead generation.
Lead generation is the practice of finding potential customers and engaging them strategically. It doesn't make leads exist out of thin air. It refines the process of capitalizing on people's existing interest. Now, there's already a lot of great advice out there on the topic.
Imagine a gun that you shoot and it just fires and sprays bullets absolutely everywhere. You're gonna kill a few people.
But after working closely with Enviro, an AI agency specializing in lead generation, we figured we had a couple nuggets of wisdom worth dropping. So lead generation can be broken down into finding leads, qualifying leads, determining which ones are worth pursuing and which are best suited for which services, and following up on leads. Finding leads starts by putting out something people will flock towards, like a YouTube video or content, making yourself exist and ideally stand out in this crowded market. You can do cold outreach, which is awesome. I guess ads technically qualify too, but that's a whole other story. Anyway, to reel them in, you have to offer value. Things like free trials, guides, info sessions, all of which, one, require that they give you their contact information, and two, give you more opportunities to assess their likelihood of becoming paying customers based on how they interact with the materials you give them. It's not enough for a person to show high intent behavior, or even to express explicit interest. A qualified lead is someone who does all that, but is also in a position to pull the trigger, and has the right profile for your product. Trying to sell enterprise plans to entry-level devs, that would be like making an intern the face of your brand. It's also important to make sure you and your customers are on the same page before anything gets signed. True story, I sit between the sales team and the growth team, and I've learned that a big part of this business is aligning expectations between vendors and clients. Because acquiring customers is great and all, but it's not going to do you any good if they sign up on false pretenses. Pretty much everything we've talked about so far is about the information you've gathered about the lead. Now it's time to engage your lead. In this step, you nurture a sense of trustworthiness, showing your ability to deliver on whatever it is your business offers. On one extreme end, you can call them. It's about the most high-effort engagement you see, which is why it's saved for vetted, high-potential leads. On the other end, you can continue to nurture the relationship with more subtle, regular communication. That might be a newsletter with case studies and testimonials or content updates. It obviously has a less immediate payoff, but it's a great low-effort way of warming up a lead who might not be ready to pull the trigger right away. This is your opportunity to prove that your business can meet their need. This is starting to sound like dating advice. Okay, AI lead generation, that's the name of the movie, is about using the subtleties of AI and its automation capabilities to identify intent and viability buried in the nuances of people's behaviors and profiles. So like, is this person likely to buy my product? You can go through their profile and their online activity and try to make an educated guess. Are you gonna do that manually? Like, for every person? You can old school automate this, like with an algorithm. You know, if company size is greater than X and person's position is either A, B, or C. But that'll be pretty low fidelity. This is where AI comes in. Machine learning algorithms let you agglomerate all different data that you collect on people and turn that into a predicted outcome. In this case, their likelihood of converting, buying. This sounds luxurious, but frankly, using AI for lead generation is more of a necessity at this point if you want to keep up with other businesses. Here's a bunch of ways that you could augment lead gen with AI. Rank a user's viability for various of your products or services based on an incoming email. Integrate with HubSpot to store a record for that lead and update automatically as you continue to correspond with them. Scrape info from a user's social media profile page to predict which services they might be interested in. Predict a user's likelihood of purchasing a product or service based on the interactions with your website or social media pages. Have a chatbot converse with someone and gauge their potential as a client and the services they might be interested in. Have the chatbot book appointments appointments with a human person within the conversation. Summarize chatbot conversations against a list of your company's services for salespeople to review before meeting them. Curate a newsletter of content most likely to interest individual customers. Scrape business directories like Airtable and Apollo.io for ideal business profiles. Look through past customers' records and satisfaction rates to match the most similar ones to potential customers to see which services will interest them. I said it before and I'll say it again. A good use of AI is when it doesn't call attention to itself. Notice how none of these steps involve spamming unemployed people on the fifth worst social media platform. What all these things have in common is they equip your team with helpful information to approach likely interested parties. It's by no means a replacement for humanity or competence. It is so important to point out that there are diminishing returns to automating lead generation processes. All the effort, not to mention all the money, that you pour into curating your leads is for nothing if your engagement is some recycled, off-putting spam. I spoke to Enviro's Matteo Vasileschi, someone who's built a career out of AI automation. He'll be the first to champion the use of AI for all tasks, including lead generation. And he still opts to reach out to high-value leads with a phone call. And yet, he is very successful, arguably because of this. That doesn't mean you could never opt for AI-written outreach. Just make sure it's meaningful, accurate, ideally concise, and this one might be controversial, it should be upfront about being AI. Here's an example.
Howdy, friend. Full disclosure, I'm a bot. I noticed you were having a peek at our pricing plans. How about we set up a meeting to discuss it? It'll be with a human. Promise.
AI has done all the hard work of finding and appraising leads. It's up to you to figure out the best course of action for moving forward. All right, so we understand lead generation and how AI is not only helpful, but kind of indispensable in the process. I'm gonna give you three examples of ways these have been implemented. The success and messy reality of it all will give you an idea of how AI lead generation works out in the wild. Say you're a small local business without a ton of resources, so you can't go out poaching potential clients one at a time. How do you find those leads? K&M Roofing and Contracting, a Virginia-based company that does, well, roofing and contracting, made targeted social media ads specific to the different communities they operate in. Their initiatives brought in $300,000 in revenue and over 50 positive Google business reviews. What they did is they took out ads for Google local services, targeting people who explicitly search for services like theirs. Now, the AI of it all was how they responded to those leads. Personalized, AI-generated follow-ups to customers' responses based on their location and the ads that brought them in. They focused on matters that Google reviewers considered important in their field, stuff like timeliness and staying on budget. That way, they could anticipate the expectations of potential customers and, in turn, make customers more likely to leave positive reviews. Trustworthiness. Again, this is AI in the hands of a business that operated locally, made it their business to know the communities they were operating in, and first tailored their ads based on this knowledge. So they used AI to reach out to people, but they didn't skimp on the human touch. A human has to literally climb on your roof to do their job. Maybe you're flooded with incoming business, so much so that you have a hard time prioritizing or triaging incoming requests. What do you do then? Bay Brothers General Contracting is a construction and restoration firm in the DC area. Adding a chatbot to their website helped reduce response time from a couple hours down to just a few minutes. How'd they do that? Incoming requests were anywhere from regular maintenance or general inquiries to urgent disaster response, like active leaks. And they were answering these inquiries manually, which meant off-hours inquiries were getting dropped, a lag between getting and responding to inquiries, and there was no established system for classifying and prioritizing emergencies. So, they added a chatbot to their website. It would gather the information it needed, and behind the scenes, an AI agent would classify the urgency of the user's request, gather other information like the kinds of service they need and whether they fall into the company's operations radius. In the event of an emergency, it would automatically set up a consultation in a time slot reserved for emergencies. Otherwise, it would let the customer book a regular appointment. On top of that, automating FAQ responses helped filter out the clients whose needs wouldn't match their services. As a result, they managed to reduce response time from 1 to 2 hours down to under 10 minutes and saw a 15% increase in leads. Plus, the whole operation is saving them about $1,600 monthly. K&M did a great job of getting folks to come to them, but if you operate remotely or on a larger scale, you might need to contact people directly. So, how do you do that with AI? without sounding like AI. Vanta does security and compliance automation, basically tools and processes to help companies comply with privacy and security regulations. Pretty much every SaaS company needs this service, so there's a big pool of potential clients, but they can't operate without it, so you gotta get to them fast or someone else will scoop them up. Vanta uses Clay's AI functionality to scrape different sources for information on companies and employees, stuff like size, revenue, jurisdiction, and who's in charge of choosing the compliance software at the company. Then they monitor RSS news feeds for stuff like hiring and funding announcements, changing in security regulations, and what have you. They update their tables in real time with incoming data, and high potential companies, ones that are likely to buy from them, are automatically entered into the CRM along with the scraped data. That CRM profile is then assigned to the most suitable sales rep, with a summary of the services they'd likely be interested in and a task to reach out to the relevant person at the company. In Vanta's case, AI in lead generation is used to figure out which sales rep should poach which employee from what company for what service. It's a tongue twister. That is a massively complex problem for a person to try and figure out, but it's where machine learning thrives. It saves their team hours on research and decision making. It even catches details that people are likely to miss. So there you have it. Three case studies, each more beautiful than the last. What are the takeaways here? And how do you use these examples to help get you started? One, use AI to augment your skills. You don't use it to fill a skill gap. Use it to expedite the processes that you already understand. AI scraping and summarizing can get pricey, so Vanta has to be sure they know which information they need. The same goes for Google Ads. K&M has to be sure folks will actually click them. Two, lead generation isn't a replacement for good business practices. These case studies show how trusted businesses improve their ability to communicate with clients. They still have to roll up their sleeves and follow through on their services. And three, if you hit me up on LinkedIn, you'd better be a fucking human. Thanks for watching. If you want the article this video is based on, I'll leave it in the description. Links to the case studies are also down there. You can also check out my full interview with Mateo Vasileski, an AI lead gen veteran, where we talk about his approach to lead generation and why it's not enough to just AI a business. Let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next. And until then, happy bot building.